When a healthy ER doctor in Seattle became sick with COVID-19, people were worried, but no one thought 44-year-old Ryan Padgett would die.
Please, can I get some help in here?
And yet, he almost did. Doctors then figured out it wasn't the virus that was killing Padgett. It was his own immune system.
My immune system had caught this wildfire, this cytokine storm.
To attack an invader, proteins called cytokines signal the immune system to move in. But some illnesses, including SARS, can trigger too many signals or a cytokine storm. The immune system then goes haywire, attacking the body. A growing number of early studies suggest a subgroup of patients with severe COVID-19 might have cytokine storm syndrome.
There's probably multiple components to why people are susceptible. It could be genetic.
Scientists in London, Ontario, are leading an important trial. Using blood samples from 45 COVID-19 patients, they found high levels of a specific cytokine protein.
What we're seeing seems to be occurring in all of the very sick patients and those that ultimately are dying.
Based on final results, drug companies can quickly develop treatments targeting certain cytokines to bring down that immune response. But it can be tricky. These scientists have done it for other illnesses and warn if the immune system's defenses are lowered, it might not attack the virus.
If we suppress the cytokine too much, the virus will replicate and go crazy.
Based on severe COVID-19 cases seen in China, Padgett's doctors tried an experimental treatment. An existing drug quieted the cytokine storm in his immune system. Treatments like it might save other lives too. Christine Burak, CBC News, Toronto.